Double Diamond Railroad back. Just came down to start another session of soldering. Yesterday we worked on this and got a bunch of stuff wired up underneath. All the whites. Still got to do the red commons. Got these ran out. Got the fork terminals on there, which fit. I didn't know if they would fit. My screws on those selectors. It does. Got that. Get those wired up after a while. But we're in a soldering mode right now. We already did a new one. Oh, here we go with the shadows right there. That guy right there. Yesterday, got him up. That's track one on the switch over here on the right. And instead of what I had here, it's right down there somewhere. The old one, feet are right there. Instead of that, I came around more to the midpoint of this main line and soldered in where this marker pin is on the back side. Can't see it. And I'm shadowing from the spots. So I got one back there on the main line, the westbound main line. Put another one down here, joined in that fork. Feed that thing. Having to rewire how some of these are. It's like, let's see, that's number two back there, that main. And this is three. Both of those are three. Then four for these two. Then we're going to be five, six for those two, seven, and eight. Back here in the back is eight. That's what we're doing now. We got a feeder up there, which would be four that lead into the yard. Separate power there. I'm going to have to do a bunch of gaps again. I got power out here, number two again. A second feeder for number two to cover that distance. And there's a feeder for four out there to be feeding in ahead of the points. So we're going to be cutting a lot of gas. But again, first thing I'm going to do is strip these and solder them all down. Then I can see that and know where to gap then. So that's the project for now. Got to get to work. Another probably an hour and a half of work here. Depends how it goes. I'll catch y'all later. Thanks for watching. Double Diamond Railroad out. Okay, we're back. Several hours of work. About 4 hours, I think, altogether. And a bunch of little issues. Soldering, I missed solder. Went back, soldered more, then I found two more I missed. Had to bring it all back out again. Go from soldering to cutting, soldering, cutting, back and forth. Got all this in. Not that happy with it, but it'll work. Soldered all those terminals on the to the wire to make sure it's better than a crimp. So right now I got a problem between mainline two, switch two, and four. Getting some kind of back feeding. When two's on, it's coming down in and running down three, track three, which is these guys, all those four tracks right there for right now. Not broken out, it didn't put the other switch on. I'm just going to tie all this back to number four like I had before. Break it out later. I've done the cuts and wiring to do it. Separate channels, but it's confusing enough now. So I went and cut more gaps. I thought, what is going on? Somehow the power is getting down the line. I put a gap here. I knew I'd have to have one there. That's breaking a common side. And then I went over and broke that side. Because that's a feeder side. Because I want two to be there and four to be here on that side of it. So then four should feed all the yard. All this down here should be four. And I've got them all broke. I'm just going to tie them together for now for testing. Maybe I'll put the selector switch on after that, make it 5, 6, 7, 8. So, I don't know. I cut this and I thought, aha, I stopped it. And then I found out that power was going down three somehow. I don't get that because right there is a gaps bender all along. I don't know how three can be on getting power from two. Can't understand that. So, double gap there. And to retrace everything over here. So I thought, well, this comes back to main two over here. Ties in, I got a gap here, which is true. So I cut the one in the back. Cut one back there, cut a gap there, and I still had feedback, so I cut the front where the common is, ahead of the common, just to totally isolate it so switch four would control that whole lead and in the yard then. So I don't know. I think we might have the wire for number two was back in here somewhere. Yeah, up there. It's back there. I'm wondering, since four's right there, I'm wondering when she went underneath that she pulled four and tied it into switch two on the selector. That's the only thing I can figure out. So we're going to have to go underneath again and trace out the wires, first of all, because I'll never get it straight from up here if it's like that. So what a mess. Again, it gets really confusing breaking all this down. And why two's going to three back here, I have no idea. I just don't get that at all. One thing I do see is right, I see one insulator right there, but I don't see any on this one in front of it. So I guess it could be coming down there. That would feed these two. How it gets over there, I don't know, when there's a gap there. That's got me baffled. We're going to trace everything out again. I need another gap cut somewhere. But I don't get it because the wire, feeder wire is right here somewhere. Right in front of those, yeah, right there. So that's number three feeder. And then the feeder, there's a feeder in here going in. There's a double cross over there to the other track, jump ring. From before, I had trouble with that switch, so I don't know, may have to cut all that loose, get that old jumper. I cut one end off, didn't change a thing. So lots to figure out tomorrow. We got a Buckeye game and Michigan State at noon. So it'll be a challenge. Try to come down, work in the morning. Okay, guys, that's all for now. Double Diamond Railroad, have a good night, have a great weekend.